Hello.
Welcome to Taco Tuesday. Taking actions
for creative ownership.
May the sunset begin.
Hello, everybody.
Hello, hello.
Welcome to Taco Tuesday. I'm Mark Wheeler.
I'm Sharon G.
And we are here to talk about creative ownership and what that means. Woo!
Boy, is it evolving.
It really is evolving. And you know, our impetus to do this Taco Tuesday today was because, speaking of our creative ownership, it was 6 years ago that we did our infamous steeple show.
The Rock Theater, Find Your Own Steeple.
And it was at that point that we really began to take our ownership in this. Because there was a time when I was not taking creative ownership. There was just stuff going on in my life that kept me from... Actually, there was stuff going on in my head that kept me from recognizing and going for what I really wanted to do. I had all this chatter in my head, and it was quite a time. And I, even though I still go through that a little bit now, I'm so much more clearer with who I am as an artist and what I want to bring.
And the value of it too, huh?
And the value of it, yeah.
Come on, I bet there's some artists out there who are willing to pay their dues. Sometimes some of us pay our dues a long, 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 long time before we realize the value. And then some people are just really early bloomers, not me, and value it right out of the gate.
Speaking of the value, it's been a good long road for me to realize the value of what I'm doing as an artist. And there were times when I thought, you know, if I'm in the band and I got all the right gear and I'm up there on stage doing it, that it should just kind of happen. I should just get the record deal, right? And there was a long time when I was a bit bitter and just not really sinking my teeth into my creative ownership. And it was a difficult time. But since our steeple show, it just really changed. And it's still changing, but I've really come a long way in my creative ownership.
It seemed like that might have even been the beginning of the idea that the songs are writing us.
I think you're absolutely right.
The song messages are intentions, and maybe originally it felt like their intentions for other people. And maybe even for the world.
Right, we were singing the songs for other people. However,
you learn how to find your own steeple.
Right, you learn.
You people need to find it.
Because we already got it, huh, happening, right? And it's like, no, wait. Right. We were writing those songs for our own growth in our own artistic output. That's what was really going on.
And now we're taking everyone along. But actually, 6 years ago, yeah, something, you know, a big insight.
Something dynamic happened.
That we could open things up. We saw glimmers, little sparkling desires in other people to do something. And guess what? They weren't doing anything with it.
And we're talking about the steeple show, like we were bringing people the idea that they could do something more with their lives.
So we helped like at least 10 others. We brought them into the show. We actually coached some of them through it, that, you know, remember, you kind of like, you want to act, you want to be a dancer, you like being out on the stage. Well, have we got a role for you?
Yeah.
Or, hey, you've healed yourself, right, in some way.
Mm-hmm.
Bring that healing in front of our band, and let's, like, bring it out to the community.
And often, we had to talk with people 3 times, 4 times before they even wanted to come over and do like a little bit of a rehearsal and just get a taste of what they could possibly do. It really took some prompting of the people that we were bringing in to get them up to speed with their intention.
And there were the late night phone calls, like, I don't know, what do you really want me to do?
Right. People were confused. It's like, you want me to do what? Or what am I supposed to do?
Yeah, I don't know if I
want to
do
that,
this.
But I don't know if I can. Yeah, I don't know if I can do that. It's been such a long time, I don't know if I'm going to be good at it. It sounds great, but
how will I know when it's the right time?
Yeah.
And actually, 2 people in the show, were even in the hospital the week of the show, they were on the verge of their own health challenges, mentally and physically, and you know what? They came through in the show. I mean,
everybody came through.
It was a cathartic, amazing thing. Even bringing in 2 opera singers who certainly were very well versed in singing Italian arias, but they had never just been able to explore in a rock band and sink their teeth into something that was new and current.
And they also put together their own physical act where they did some really interesting movements while they were singing and not singing, and they were just flowing back and forth. They made it up all themselves, and we were like, that sounds great, do it.
We want you to evolve.
Yeah.
So, wow. And then it's funny, like, once you do something like that, I mean, as the newspapers, you know, there were newspapers 6 years ago. Long Beach had a local newspaper called the Press Telegram that covered the story, as well as the Long Beach Post. And the story is like some 300 people showed up on the streets of downtown Long Beach for the Slushbox Find Your Own Steeple. And after that, it was like going in and playing a nightclub and slamming out a set just wasn't like enough.
Yeah, after us doing a show like that and bringing in all the people and all the coaching we did and just mentoring people to do what they really want to do, it seemed like playing a bar was just like, wait, why are we here? I mean, what's the purpose of it? Because we gained a new purpose after that show, and there was a bigger calling for us, a bigger ownership.
That kind of kicked us in gear to do some concerts at Greenbow Gardens that were ticketed events that were custom for the season, and a cathartic component was in each of those to help people grow. It actually became like therapy for everyone there, including us.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That was a big, big thing.
So when we were talking about earlier about how the songs were writing us, I also feel like that was the beginning of our mentorship. That was like the impetus of us saying, wait a minute, man, we just helped all these people with their artistic process, and it was like some time had to go by to give a hindsight as to what we really accomplished, because it was a lot. And we helped so many, well, we helped the people that were in our show so much. It was like, wait, maybe there's something going on here that's more than just us performing. Maybe there's like a mentorship thing that's evolving in us naturally through us and through our songs and what our message is.
Then some people, gosh, one in particular said, you know, some of your music and your enthusiasm helped me go through treatments for cancer and gave me some hope that I could do this.
Yeah.
That I really do have some thriving green energy inside of my heart that I can follow. And it's so funny, I think, though, there was a lull, though, since that show and since some of the Greenbow shows, there's been, you know, we've had our own turmoil. Like, what are we doing here? What
what's
is it
the
worth?
Mission? What's our mission here? Because it's like, I don't know, we're like easily falling gracefully into this, do I dare say, coaching? But it's really like what it is we're naturally driven to. We just recently had a client with us for 3 months, and he wanted to be a comedian, but he used to do comedy, and he got out of it because somebody told him that he sucked, and he believed it. He believed it.
For many years.
Many years.
He probably still believes it on a certain level.
He might still believe it.
But he's cracking through.
And we were calling him once a week and just giving him like some time and talking with him about it and pushing his envelope of what comedy is to him and helping him understand his passion and not to let it go.
Because if you have an urge inside of you, or had an urge inside of you, even decades ago, from the decades we've had together so far in our creative ownership journey, we really know the value that can bring to your life by honoring the urges.
Yep.
That's what we're doing now, is helping people to honor those urges and actually begin to take steps to claim what they have had a sense they're here for, or what they once sensed brought them a lot of joy or lit them up.
One of the favorite things for us to do is to get on a phone call with somebody and help them even find what it is that they might be interested in doing for themselves, a process, an art process, or anything. It's really an amazing process that we both love to do, and we both do it at the same time, and we help individuals in that manner.
In stereo.
In stereo.
So Happy Taco Tuesday.
Happy Taco Tuesday.
Taking action for creative ownership.
And
it's a journey. And we would love to help you with the journey. If you're feeling an urge inside.
So.
But maybe you don't know what in the hell to do about it. Or it's not worth doing now. I'm retired.
I'm too old. Or I'm, or I'm too young.
It's for my kids to do. Or for my grandkids to do. Or for those other people. On blah, 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 blah show.
Right.
Let them deal with all of that stuff. We all have something. We all have stuff to bring out.
So let's bring it out.
Yes.
That is the conclusion.
Yeah, you know where to find us.
You know where to find us.
Leave us a comment if you'd like us to reach out, or please reach out to us right on this media where you might be watching right now.
Yeah.
And we're here to help you bring it out.
So bring it out.
Ooh. Happy Taco Tuesday.
Tuesday.
Ooh. It's worth it. Take action.
You are worth it.